the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God will walk with me down streets where no one else will walk. God will talk with me about things of which no one else will talk.
For our Goodnight message on this Thursday, the 16th of December 2021, broadcasting from the Salesian Pontifical University, Rome, Italy, by your servant Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to this encouraging message in line with the first reading of today on this first day of the novena to Christmas, entitled Fear Not, the Lord is with you.
Are there. God will care for me whenever there is no one else to care.
Today we began the novena to Christmas, even though on our Daily Bread family we started yesterday. The official day of Christmas novena is today, where we hear the assurance of the Lord as we end the first part of our preparations for Christmas, which was emphasizing the second coming of Christ. And tomorrow we are going to focus on the first coming of Christ, that actual coming that had to do with his birth into human form. And as God is concluding with the people of Israel in Deuteronomy, towards the end of the exile, he promises them that he is coming back to stay with them. He is coming back to restore the glory of Jerusalem, the barren one, the one who was left desolate after the destruction of Jerusalem temple in 587 BC, with the exile experience that left many of them devastated. And indeed, Jerusalem remained like a widow, expecting that one day the husband would come back, God himself. And God promised to restore that relationship, to remove the fear from Jerusalem. He says these words, "Fear not, for you will not be ashamed. Be not confounded, for you will not be disgraced. For you will forget the shame of your youth and the reproach of your widowhood. You will remember no more. For your Maker is your husband. The Lord of hosts is his name. And the Holy One of Israel is your Redeemer. The God of all the earth, he is God." What an assurance to Jerusalem that lived in fear, to Jerusalem that thought it was a divorce. No, it was just a separation. It wasn't a divorce. God is coming back to stay with us as the Emmanuel. And his staying with us will be forever. The Emmanuel is coming to pitch a tent in our midst. And so if there is anything you are afraid of in your life, you have to remember that God has already put his dwelling among human beings. He tells us in Matthew chapter 28 verse 20, "Behold, I'm with you always until the end of time." So if ever you are afraid of anything, I want you to understand that God is here with us and he wants you to rely on him. He tells us in Matthew chapter 6 verse 33 to 34, "Seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. Therefore do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own." There should not be anything to worry you in your life, because you have God with you. But I know we all have our fears, especially now when we hear of the variant of COVID-19 known as Omicron, and many scientists telling us it's a very dangerous variant. We have to know God is telling us not to be afraid. But will this remove the fears we have? because we have fears of the future. We have financial troubles. We have health concerns that leave fear within us. We have failure or pain, and we can find it difficult to practice letting go of these fears. However, with Christ, we do not have to let feelings of fear control our lives. When we realize the value of letting go of our fears and giving them to Christ, we can find genuine peace. Faith must be above fear. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in Him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Romans chapter 15 verse 13. On our own, we can find it difficult not to let anxious thoughts occupy our minds and ideas. However, when we rely not on our own strength, but on God's power, we can find that our anxieties and stresses do not overtake us. We can find many references to have faith over fear and trusting in God in difficult times. Psalm 27 verse 1 says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is a stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?" We can put our faith in God, our stronghold, when we are afraid, and He can help us let go of our fears. He has a plan for our lives and did not create us to be fearful. 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7. When we have God on our side, we need not be afraid. With Christ in our lives, we know that there is hope for the future. Luke chapter 25 verse 25 says, "Who of you by worrying can add a single hour to your life? Fear does nothing for us, while trust and hope enrich our lives." Psalm 118 verse 6 says, "The Lord is with me, I will not be afraid. What can mere mortals do to me?" The author of Psalm 118 says, "I will not be afraid." Sometimes we have to tell ourselves the same thing. We know that God is in control and He is trustworthy. In the words of the famous hymn and the children's songs, "He's got the whole world in His hands. So why are we still afraid?" The first reading we had today in Isaiah 54 verse 1 to 10 stressed, "The God of the whole earth, He is God." That is His name. The God of the whole earth is got the whole world in His hands. And if He's got the whole world in His hands, we've only to submit ourselves into His hands and say, "Lord, have it your way." Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.
God will talk with me when friends forget and fail to.